Hi everyone. Today I thought of taking a topic which is based on India's initiative of bringing 121 nations together and form an alliance and organizations, which is going to help almost all nations in the world to lessen their reliability over the non-renewable source of energy and come up with something which is known as a clean source of energy. So today we are going to talk about International Solar Alliance. So the World Bank has already come up with one global solar atlas where it has mentioned that where the maximum solar energy is there. So you could find that here in this portion, there's a lot of solar energy is here in this portion, in Australia also. So if we are able to tame this energy, you know, it will be really very helpful. One thing that you need to understand is the one day solar energy that you are able to tame, if the world is going to tame that, it is enough to fulfill the energy requirement of the world for 1 year. So you could understand that how much abundant energy is there. So the sun is one source of energy. If we are using it in a right way, our dependency over the energy on the basis of the fossil fuel will surely going to drop down drastically. So quickly, let's start it how it goes. The area where the maximum sun rays are going to fall is in between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So that is already in the highlighted area. International Solar Alliance, it is the alliance between 121 solar rich countries, which partially or fully going to fall between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. It was launched on 30th November 2015 in Paris by the Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, and then the President of France, Mr. Francois Hollande. It was in the 21st Conference of Parties, that is what United Nations, you know, call people for the on the climate change. So there it was decided that we need to form such organizations, and the foundation stone was laid on 25th January 2016, and then it was on 15 November 2016 in Morocco on the sideline of Conference of Parties 22nd conference. After 1 year, everything was ready and we had the framework. So the objective is very clean. We want to use more of the clean energy. First is that. Second is how to finance these projects, because whenever you are starting something new, you need a lot of financial support from the organization. So we want to engage the international organization like World Bank so that they can give loan to the nations and they can use more technology so that they can tame the solar energy. And the position has created, as I said, it is more about the funding and transfer of the technology. For example, if my country is having some technology, I can also share it with the rest of 121 nations. So that is about it. And it is also expected that by 2030, because of the climate change, by 2030 there are few targets that is given to every nation. So we want to abide by the sustainable development goals. So that is why ISA has been formed. So far, there are 121 nations, as I said earlier. 81 of them have already signed on the framework agreement of ISA. There are two more countries. Eritrea is one of the countries, and second is Saint Kitts and Nevis. This country is in Africa, East Africa, and this country is in the Caribbean islands. So these two are the more countries which has also signed on the framework agreement of ISA. There are 58 countries which are legally binding by the norms, because it is ratified by their parliament, their constitution body. So ISA is really become a big organization now. And if you see the Tropic of Cancer, there are 8 states which are going to fall in this, and definitely because these are the states which are falling here. So Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram are the nations where the maximum sunlight is going to fall. And as I said that by 2022, the Prime Minister has already decided by 2022, 175 gigawatt of the energy will be based on the renewable source of energy. So out of that, 100 gigawatt will be only coming out from the solar panels. So that is the target. $26 million is the corpus fund, which is already formed. The government of India has already established a National Institute of Solar Energy that everyone should be knowing. And the head office of that is Gurugram. So there's an institute which has been established so that all research work can be done. And 5 acres of land is already allocated to it. As I said, 160 crore is the sum that has been allocated to this organization. like Reserve Bank of India, which is taking care of all the banking, though in the today's news, it is really very sad that Yes Bank has, you know, if you have an account in Yes Bank, you cannot withdraw your money more than 50,000 rupees a month. And I think in one go, you cannot withdraw more than 5,000, which is really a sad news for the country like India, where people rely a lot on the banking sector. So Indian Renewable Energy Departmental Development Agency is IREDA, and the Solar Energy Corporation of India are the two organizations which are going to contribute $1 million in the ISA Corpus Fund, $1 million each. So there will be $2 million of the Corpus Fund. Along with that, today, India's all energy, 18.5% of that is coming from the renewable source of energy, which is coming out to be 58 gigawatt. But by 2030, the 40% of the power generation will be from the clean energy, will be based on the renewable source of energy. Fine. And the government of India, as I said, 175 gigawatt of renewable energy by 2022 is what they have targeted. 100 gigawatt out of them would be based on the solar energy. Let's see how the projects are going on, and some of the projects are already there in the pipeline. You can see in the solar energy, it is 32.53 is already installed capacity. So they're already generating the electricity. There are 25 gigawatt is under implementation, and there are few which are tendered. So tender is already given. Now in next 1-2 years, they are going to generate that electricity so that the target of 2022 can be achieved. So overall 83.36 is they're already in the installed or they are already tendered. But the target is to take it to 100 gigawatt of the energy. Similarly, if you look at the wind energy, 49.12 is generated by the wind energy. So far, wind energy is higher because earlier government has focused more on the wind energy than the solar energy. And the bioenergy is also there. Now the government is also trying to use it because a lot of, you know, garbage is coming out from the cities. They want to use it so that the, you know, bioenergy can be generated. Small hydro projects, the government is focused, has completely changed from the big projects where a lot of people have, you know, shifted from one place to other places. And most of the time, these deals are always in, you know, court and conflict. So that is the reason why the government is planning to go for more small hydro projects. Similarly, there is a wind solar hybrid type of projects also there. So overall, the target is so far it is 150 gigawatt of the one which is in tendered or in the project. As I said earlier, the target is 175 gigawatt. So now let's go ahead. The next part is, which is really very important, is I'm sure that you have heard many a time the government ministers who are saying, the union government minister who are saying, we are going to double the income of farmers. So one of that thing is PM Kusum Yojana. It is Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uttan Mahabhiyan. So what they are doing is they can see that they cannot increase the food prices. If the food prices increases, it is the middle class which is going to impact it because of the inflation. So what they have planned is, can we rope up these farmers so that they are going to generate electricity on the basis of solar panel? So for example, I'm having a land which is not that, you know, irrigation wise, it is not that great, or maybe the fertility of the land is not very high. So what I can do is I can put the solar panels there and connect it with the DISCOM companies. So that is power distribution company. So I give now, you know, energy, electricity to the distribution company, and they're forwarding it to the other places. Similarly, if you look at the development of ultra mega renewable energy power parks, that is what is going on in Jaisalmer and another part of India, where the huge parks have been formed, the solar parks have been formed. A lot of energy is generated, a lot of energy is tamed and then converted to electric energy and transferred to the cities and the nearby areas. Similarly, there is a grid connected rooftop solar. A few, you know, days back, I was reading about how the Germany has transformed itself, moving from the nuclear energy to the solar energy. So there was a time when people were like us, they were taking energy from, they were taking electricity connection from the DISCOM company. Today, what they are doing is almost a big part of, you know, Germany is, their rooftops are covered by the solar panel. So they are generating electricity. They are the one who are using that electricity on their own. And whenever it is the extra electricity, they're giving it back to the DISCOM companies, which are further giving it to the, you know, the industries and other places. So that is also the government's plan, where they want to tame the energy on every rooftop. Now there's Atal Jyoti Yojana. Also the government has launched it. 75% of the money is given by the Ministry of Renewable Sources of Energy and 25% is given by MPLAD fund. If you see, 3 lakh, more than 3 lakh street light have been put in there in the Gram Panchayat, in the Jilla Panchayat, sometime at the block level as well, in the states like UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, Assam, so that the, you know, the electricity reliability over the non-renewable source of energy should go down. Now, this is what the chart that is given by NICE. Here, what they are saying is, these are the areas where the maximum solar energy is falling. So they are planning to tame it here. If you see, the two areas is Jammu and Kashmir, and second is Rajasthan. One of the reason, after abrogation of Article 370, the government intention is very clear that they want to generate more jobs there and making it economically viable. So there, the maximum investment, if you see, they have already put in the target in Rajasthan. They have put the highest, which is coming out to be 142.31 megawatt of the electricity will be generated. While in Jammu and Kashmir, it is number 211 gigawatt of the energy will be generated. The overall, it is coming out to be somewhere around 750 gigawatt of the energy that could be tamed across India. Now, the first assembly of the International Solar Alliance has already happened on the Mahatma Gandhi's birthday on 2nd October to 5th October 2018. And the one who is the president of it is the Minister of New and Renewable Energy and the Power Minister. So if you see, it is joint by Indian Minister as well as the Minister of State for Ecological and Inclusive Transition, that is Government of France. So both of them are the president in this. And here the important thing that you need to understand is that Star C is one thing that they have launched, and there's an Infopedia. Now try to understand what is it. For example, I'm having something which is technology. By using that technology, I'm going to get a benefit. So what I do is I will get it patented and then sell it to the only other nations by taking a good money from it. The good part that is done here is that is, you know, covering all the nations is that whatever the technological advancement that I have, I'm going to share it with all the nations, all 121 nations, or maybe the nations who have signed the framework of agreement. And I can share the technology there. Whatever I have used, whatever I have, you know, used and I failed or I got success, I'm going to share it with all the nations. So the mistake that I'm doing, not every nation is going to do the same mistake. And whatever is the outcome of that, I am going to share it with the people or with the other nations. That is the beauty of this alliance. So that's why it is not an organization, it is an alliance. And the second one happened on 31st October 2019 in Delhi. And it is attended by all the diplomats and ISA member countries delegates. What is the use of it? The first thing is they have a solar cyber center. So 24/7, any type of help that you want, it is available there. The second important thing is we want to replace all non-renewable sources of energy with a renewable source of energy like coal, petrol, and all these things. So the carbon footprint that we are releasing, we want to also control that. And we are also trying to convince the financial institutions so that they can give us loan and we can set up these projects. Now, to summarize all this, whatever we have discussed is $83 billion is what India is required for to generate 175 gigawatt of the energy by 2022. If you see all the nation, overall target of all nations is by 2030, they are going to generate 1,000 gigawatt of electricity, out of which 100 gigawatt of the electricity will be generated by India only. And that is what they are going to generate by 2022. So by 2030, of course, our contribution will be highest. There is total $1 trillion of investment is required in all these nations. 73% of the global population is going to fall in the area in these 121 countries where there is abundance of solar energy. But they are only contributing 36% of the world GDP. So that is which is really hurting. 55% of total energy consumption of worldwide. We have solar energy. We are not able to use it. We are using the fossil fuel and we are using the highest energy. That is 55% of the energy is used by these nations. And so far, there is only 23% of the installed capacity in the solar in these nations. So you can understand the nations which are not the part of it, the nations where the solar light is not really falling at a high intensity, they are the ones which are gaining or taking the benefit of it. While these nations, where there's abundance of solar energy, they are not able to use the same thing. So thank you so much. I hope you liked it. Please share your experiences and comments. Anything that you feel that I should also include, please mention that as well. Thank you. The next video will be soon going to come over the deal between Taliban and USA. I hope you will also like it. Thank you so much. Thank you.